So Sonia asked, what kind of reset are there? I said, it's like, you can do an artificial coma, you can do sleep, but what else is there? Is there anything else that, we know is a reset for us? Means after we do this, we feel fresh again, we have a new approach. What else?
Meditation.
Meditation, for example, and Sonia does yoga, is a yoga teacher, so yoga for sure does it, yes? But what else?
The infection. Infections have been known to reset bodies.
Infections, for example, it can be, for example, a fever. That's, this is what nature does. It gives you a fever. Or it does, like yesterday we talked with what's the doctor's name?
Dr. Lodi.
Dr. Lodi. They do cancer treatment by taking out some blood, then destroying it kind of, and putting it back into the into some tissues where you get actually an inflammation. I tell you, you use water and just put it in, and you, once you get the inflammation, and you get the same results, because it's a reset. It's a reset that the shamans always used. What do they do? Oh, we'll do some. After my accident, I was still informationally very much into this loop of losing my wife, losing everything I knew was. So I was still in this loop. And then somebody suggested, go to this temple here in Chiang Mai. They do some cleaning ritual and they do some protective ritual. And what did the monk do? He said, oh, we can give you a tattoo, and that's your protective tattoo. I say, I don't like tattoo, I hate. Ah, no problem, we can give you an invisible tattoo. okay. Then I say, what do you want to do? I want it here, okay. And then he started the old fashioned way, like with something that he heated up in the fire, and okay. So what is this doing? It's of course a reset. I mean, you see this being heated up in the fire, and you know, soon you will have it on your skin, yes? So, no, it's protective, very protective. This is all the superstition part. Once you've gone through this, you had a reset. Because it's something so unfamiliar that you don't even remember why you came. So, and then the next thing is Deborah was there sitting next, and she said, but that's not invisible. Oh, yes. So, later we understood he didn't understand what means visible and invisible. So, it's still there, I see. But I don't mind it, because it really did its job. I know, yes? Another reset, can you tell you also from Chiang Mai, actually we tried to do it, we go see to find the same place on Wednesday. The monk there, he said, what do you have? Okay, all the negative stuff, put it in these eggs. You have to bring eggs, okay.
Don't tell everything.
Huh?
Don't tell everything.
No. We will get to some other monk. They have all different techniques. It's all the same thing, you see. It's all the same thing. But what did he do? Lie down, okay. So now you project everything in those eggs. Yes, so all this negative stuff goes into the eggs. And then he had prepared some water. There were all people who were all sitting around him. So from everybody he took some water, and then he had some teas, tiger teas, elephant teas, everything. He was rubbing the teas into the water, yes? And then, now think about all the negative stuff, yes? And when we were really lying there, trying to take everything into the eggs, he spit at us the whole mouthful of water, yes? A monk, imagine, a monk spitting at you. So, this is a reset.
What else he said? Now take this leftover of water and drink a sip of everything.
Check the leftover water that everybody had drunk, and then he put all the old teas in them. Drink now, this is water, yes? See, this is simple, but I mean, do it. Another thing, I was once, I had the chance in a big auditorium, there was the Dalai Lama speaking. And then by amazing good luck. He said, who wants to come for dinner with me? Like, there was like 10,000 people, but then only 10 people he'd choose like this. It was simple, and I was one of them. And they went to dinner. And then, what is the Dalai Lama eating in a restaurant? What is he eating?
Lamb.
Huh? Vegetable and this in the ritual. No.
Steak.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Wheel.
So what is this? He's teaching something and doing something different or what? Mm-hmm. It's any teacher that really can represent what he is, you will find he is unpredictable. And he doesn't have there's many moments where you see there's a reset for you. It means there is something that comes so unexpected that this is a reset, it's an informational reset. But you can have physical reset, for example, by doing a sauna and then going into the ice cold water. You can do this by when you walk the whole day in Havaianas, as I do, then when you have a seminar, you take on some put on some boots. It's like a reset, yes? And you see those many people, if they are now banking people or new age people, they have all one thing in common, they don't change their dress. I mean, Kiran is a little bit not a good example, he is always white, but we'll maybe talk about this in a few years, maybe I'm all colorful. But it's just examples. Once I feel that this makes me sick, I can change it. But people think they can change it. But then they also, you see, they don't change it. They say, if I really wanted to change my relationship, I would change it. But there's so many good things, so I prefer to stay in this relationship because there are so many good things. So, and as the years go by, you push more and more the things that you don't like into one corner there, you don't see it, and you still think the good things are better than the bad things. So that's where we are. And that's why reset, you cannot create, fabricate usually enough for yourself. You can create more if you know the principle. But you, when there's some life-threatening situation, often the life-threatening situation itself becomes such a reset that you get healthy because you know you're probably dying, or to make a real change, then you maybe not die. But if this is not the case, you have to make more drastic steps. For example, going to a different country for some time, going outside of your, leaving your family for some time. And it's all used to some degree in when you go to a hospital. I mentioned this is such a reset. You've woken up at 5 in the morning, get all this terrible food, all the terrible environment, seeing people die, and all this is such a reset that this can be very well healing. So it's not that the New Age say, oh, we have to have a hospital where everything is very beautiful and the music is wonderfully calming and everything is colorful. Then you feel, finally my sickness brought me to a nice place. Yes, so I have to keep this. Yes, I have to keep it because it's a nice place. And maybe I come from a place where my husband would shout at me all the time, now here everybody cares for me, it's a nice, they put flowers every day. My husband forgot to put flowers 20 years ago. No, this is a good place. So this is the best place to die, of course. So it's all opposite to what usually is thought, because it's missing one aspect, the reset, because we all are programmed to feel uncomfortable with reset. We try to avoid everything. Reset, in a way, like for a computer, it does not reset itself. It has to come from outside. Huh? So.